Have you ever had the sensation that members of your farm family business expect a lot, but they don't tell you what they expect? I've had some examples of farms I've sat down with in which the junior partner is desperately trying to demonstrate that they are ready to take over this business. And there really isn't clear communication about how to do that. So they make attempts at what they think makes sense, that they're proving their worth and they're proving their ability. For example, one young farmer rented 2 extra quarters of land without consulting. He hired another part-time employee and bought some bred heifers, which in his mind was like demonstrating, I'm the leader. And instead, his senior partner, his mom and dad, were like, this is out of order. This is not right. So I would like to propose that there's a better way to have a consistent method of having a platform of communication. So having a family business meeting maybe sounds a little formal, but I would like to just keep it simple and suggest some ways that you can do that. If you set a consistent timeline in which everybody is sitting at the table and has an opportunity to contribute to what is important, what the priorities and tasks are, then they know they'll have an opportunity to voice any concerns, and it will prevent people having to guess what everybody else is thinking. So in sitting down often at tables, one of the prescriptions I would say that I made is for a farm family to buy a whiteboard and some markers and throw it up in their workshop. So here's a super simple example of that. If all of the members of the farm are sitting there and you want to agree on a to-do list, say we're just talking about the week and what has to get done, there's these 3 tasks. And amongst them, they collaborate and decide what the priorities are. So task number one, this one needs to get done first or is the highest priority, number 2, number 3. And then you can just assign who the leads are. So in this case, Barb's taking number 1, Jim's number 2, and Colin's number 3. By having this simple conversation, which literally could be a 10-minute chat, this meeting actually results in clarity. People are aligned where they're aiming, and it removes points of friction before it actually becomes conflict. So it can be a really powerful tool that isn't very difficult and actually can have great impact. Some other tips I would say along those lines are thinking about wanting to have some rules of engagement. So this is a priority for everybody to attend. So depending on the complexity and size of your farm, sometimes it could be once a week. Sometimes it could be a quarterly meeting. In some operations, they need to sit down every day and find great value in that. And actually, that was a farm that I was super excited to see them meeting quite regularly. They had actually cut back on their meetings during harvest season because they felt they were too busy. It was then that they realized that meeting every day is where they found a lot of efficiencies and when that communication became critical. And so they actually changed back to meeting every day as a result. Other rules of engagement, probably no swearing is a pretty good rule, just in terms of respect. Everybody has a voice at the table. Making sure that if there is some disagreements that they maybe have some way of resolving that or conflict resolution. Those are a few ideas. And in fact, we're gonna provide some links together with this video because maybe you wanna have some more experience in making an agenda for that meeting, or how do you lead a meeting? Or perhaps you wanna think about ways that you might wanna capture some minutes, maybe create a binder to keep track of all of those things as time goes on. Long story short, I really think it's unlikely that you're going to get to a point where you're going to have communication without doing it intentionally. Especially in families, it can be a bit of a leap. And so by starting with these little meetings and having these conversations, giving a consistent place where people can have a voice, it can make a big difference and really help people to get through the small conversations. So when it gets time to the big conversations, those will come a lot more easily. So as you can tell, farm family team meetings is a topic that I think is just provides such a value, and I'm super excited about it because it's simple and you can do it today. I just can't encourage it enough. If you are interested or would like to comment on this topic, please do so or tweet me at @Claudira.